with your loved one, you'll find an enchantment here. The night will weave its magic spell when the one you love is near. For this is the night, and the heavens are right.
This is one of Disney's most emblematic scenes. If something is emblematic, it is representative of a particular person or group. This spaghetti scene is so famous that it's not uncommon for you to come across other movies or even videos where people try to do this.
We did it.
Today we're learning English with Lady and the Tramp. We will be working with a scene from the original animation and a scene from the live action, which is more recent. But in case you're new here, our method is really simple. First, you will watch the scenes with subtitles. Then we'll teach you some of the most important vocabulary, grammar, and pronunciation from the clips. Finally, you will test your listening skills by watching the scenes again without subtitles. But before we get started and do anything else, make sure you hit that subscribe button and bell down below. Why, Thiago? Well, because every week we put out new videos like this to help you understand your favorite movies and TV series without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. Isn't that a great reason? So, hit that subscribe button and bell down below in order not to miss a single new video. Now, let's get started!
Dear. Is something wrong, Pidge?
It's morning.
Yeah. So it is.
I should have been home hours ago.
Why? Because you still believe in that ever-faithful old dog tray routine? Oh, come on, Pidge. Open up your eyes.
Open my eyes?
To what a dog's life can really be. Show you what I mean. Look down there. Tell me what you see.
Well, I see nice homes with yards and fences.
Exactly. Life on a leash. Look again, Pidge. Look, there's a great big hunk of world down there with no fence around it. But two dogs can find adventure and excitement. And beyond those distant hills, who knows what wonderful experiences. And it's all ours for the taking, Pidge. It's all ours.
It sounds wonderful.
But?
But who'd watch over the baby?
You win.
It's morning.
Yeah. So it is.
So it is a great way to playfully acknowledge or recognize what someone tells you without necessarily repeating what the other person said. Instead of, it's morning, yes, it's morning, you can go, so it is. Remember that you need to respond using the same structure of the verb tense. For example, it's morning, so it is. It's hot today. So it is. We're alone here. So we are. Here's an example.
Oh, that's a sipping whiskey.
So it is.
I should have been home hours ago.
Why?
This is a nice structure. Should plus have plus past participle. This is used to express regret about something you did or didn't do. For example, I didn't study enough, so I failed the test. I should have studied more. He lied to his mom about going to a friend's house. He should have told her the truth.
I should have been home hours ago.
Why? Because you still believe in that ever-faithful old dog tray routine?
A tray is a flat, shallow container typically used for carrying food or drinks. A dog tray is a container which looks like a tray where dogs can stay inside the house. If someone is faithful, this person is loyal and this person won't betray or leave you. Faithful is the adjective form of the noun faith. The suffix full is common to turn words into adjectives. Here are some examples. Faithful becomes faithful. Useful becomes useful. And hopeful becomes hopeful.
Oh, come on, Pidge. Open up your eyes.
Open my eyes?
To what a dog's life can really be. Show you what I mean.
I'll show you what I mean. Nice connected speech. First of all, I'll show you. This abbreviation here, I will, you say I'll show you. And then I'll show you what I mean. The T for what has a flap sound. Da 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 da. You join that da da sound with the I. So what I, what I. I'll show you what I mean. I'll show you what I mean.
Show you what I mean. Look down there. Tell me what you see.
Tell me what you see. More connected speech here. The character goes, tell me what you see. Tell me what you see. So what you see. The T for what combined with the Y for you has this ch sound. So what you see. Tell me what you see.
Tell me what you see.
Well, I see nice homes with yards and fences.
Exactly. Life on a leash.
A leash is a strap or cord used to restrain and guide a dog or other animal. Life on a leash means a life without freedom.
Look again, Pidge. Look, there's a great big hunk of world down there with no fence around it.
In this context, a hunk means a large piece of something. A great big hunk of world is a great piece or part of the world. There's also a cool expression, a hunk of junk. If a machine or piece of equipment is a hunk of junk, it doesn't work well. Here's an example.
Nice job.
This computer's a hunk of junk.
Hey, sailor, come watch what you got over here.
Where did you get this?
Look, there's a great big hunk of world down there with no fence around it. But two dogs can find adventure and excitement.
Question. The word excitement is a noun. Can you come up with the other forms of this word? Excitement, excite. Excited or exciting? Excitedly.
And beyond those distant hills, who knows what wonderful experiences. And it's all ours for the taking, Pidge. It's all ours.
It's all for the taking. This means it's all within our reach, or it's easy for us to have it. All you need is to reach for it and take it. This is a great expression, all for the taking. You can use it to say that something, like an opportunity, for example, is right in front of you, and you can easily take it.
All for the taking.
I'm sure you've been learning many nice words and expressions today, huh? But let me tell you that if you don't review this vocabulary, you will likely forget it very, very soon. If you want to be able to actually use these words you're learning today, next time you get into an English conversation, I have super exciting news to share with you today. You have to check out the Learn English with TV series flashcards on the Real Life English app. This is the newest feature of our Real Life English app, which allows you to unlock intelligent flashcards with definitions and images for the specific lesson you're watching here on the channel. Instead of having to spend a lot of time taking notes of these words, you can review all the vocabulary you're learning today on the app with just a few clicks. Plus, you get to watch this lesson inside the app, so you can transition between watching and practicing more easily. And most importantly, our app's special algorithm will present you with the vocabulary card you're learning at the exact moment you're about to forget it, so you can transfer your learning from your short-term memory to permanently remember the words. Just imagine what it would be like if you could remember all the new words from this lesson and actually use them in your conversations. Imagine how confident you would feel with your English and how people would be impressed by your large vocabulary. Imagine communicating confidently in that meeting, in that job interview, in that English test you have to take, or in that conversation with a local while traveling. So what are you waiting for? Start taking your vocabulary to the next level today with the Learn English with TV series flashcards. All you need to do is download the Real Life English app and follow the instructions so you can unlock this exclusive deck of cards for this lesson. The link will be in the description. Click on it, download it, and follow the instructions. I'll see you there.
Bye.
Lady,
you and your friend better be careful. I smell an intruder afoot.
Oh, that's him, Trusty.
Leave the police work to me.
Oh, no, it's Officer Trusty. Help. Just in the nick of time.
Hey, don't push it.
Keep your scarf on, killer.
Okay, you two. Thank you for the backup, but he was just leaving. Weren't you? Street dog?
Street dog?
Oh, I got it.
I'll go, but only because I'm free to leave while all of you are stuck behind your fences.
Just remember, when the baby moves in, the dog moves out.
I'm stealing this part away.
Hey, I let you steal that. Replaced by a baby. Ugh, makes no sense.
None?
No way.
I mean, can a baby fetch slippers?
Doubtful.
Don't be daft.
Or pick up the paper?
Lady,
you and your friend better be careful.
When you are careful, you are cautious and don't take many risks. But what I want to point out here is the opposite of careful, careless. A careless person is not cautious and takes many unnecessary risks.
You didn't file your paperwork last night.
Oh, that darn paperwork. Wouldn't it be easier if it all just blew away?
Don't let it happen again.
Yes, well, I'll try to be less careless.
As you saw in the clip just now, Mike apparently forgets to file some important paperwork for his work, so he was careless for not doing it. The words careful and careless both come from the same root, care. By the way, look at how many variations we can form with the word care. Careful. He drives slowly and with attention because he's a careful driver. Careless. She's so careless. She's always doing dangerous things like riding a motorcycle without a helmet. Carefulness. She read the document with great carefulness before signing it. Carelessness. A moment of carelessness can cost you your life. Carefully. Scared, the boy carefully opened the door to see what was inside the closet. Caring. They are such caring friends. They're always ready to help me. Uncaring. He's a really uncaring individual. He doesn't care about anybody but himself. Care. Little things like giving a simple gift shows how much you care about your partner. Isn't that amazing? This is called word formation. Word formation is this art of picking a word and coming up with different forms or formations of that word. You can use it as a verb, as an adjective, as a noun, as an adverb. Cool, isn't it?
You and your friend better be careful. I smell an intruder afoot.
An intruder is someone who invades a private property, like her house, for example. If something is afoot, it is happening in preparation to start happening soon or in progress. For example, I smell an intruder afoot as we saw in the clip, means I smell an intruder getting in the house right now. Here's another example.
Fantastic news! Someone TP'd our house. Halloween fun is afoot.
Dad, I really want to be excited for you, but Halloween? We're almost old enough to vote.
That's him, Trusty!
Leave the police work to me.
Oh no, it's Officer Trusty, help! Just in the nick of time.
Hey!
This is a funny idiom. Just in the nick of time. Just in the nick of time means at the last possible moment. For example, we got there just in the nick of time before the show started.
Just in the nick of time.
Hey, don't push it.
Keep your scarf on, killer.
The phrase don't push it is a warning, which means the same as don't provoke me. Tramp calls the other dog killer to make fun of him. Because the other dog is much smaller and doesn't look dangerous, Tramp is sarcastically calling him killer.
Keep your scarf on, killer.
Okay, you two, thank you for the backup, but he was just leaving.
Backup in this context means support or extra help. This is a common word, especially in cop movies and series. You know, when a police officer calls for backup, for example.
There they are! Stop! Hey, you, don't move! Halt!
Keep your scarf on, killer.
Okay, you two, thank you for the backup, but he was just leaving, weren't you, street dog?
Another way of saying street dog is stray dog. By the way, this is a good moment to explain the word tramp. A tramp in this context is a person with no home, job, or money, and who travels from place to place. So in this movie, Lady and the Tramp, we have a romance story between two different dogs. Lady, who has an owner, and Tramp, who doesn't have an owner and lives on the street.
None?
No way.
I mean, can a baby fetch slippers?
Doubtful.
Don't be daft. Or pick up the paper?
These are slippers. Now, the verb fetch means to get or to grab. This is a common way, actually, to talk to dogs. For example, go fetch or fetch.
What am I doing?
Doubtful. This is a great way to respond when you think something has a low chance of being true. For example, do you think you'll go to the party? Doubtful.
Well, mark my words, Mosby. Someday you'll be telling this story. You'll see it my way. Doubtful.
Daft, or doffed, is the British way to say silly, stupid. So the phrase don't be daft or don't be doffed could be, don't be silly.
Steph, that accent's really cute. Would you please stop doing it?
What accent? Oh, dotums, don't be daft.
Alright, are you having fun so far? I'm sure you are. Now is time for the best moment of the lesson. The moment when you watch the scenes again without subtitles to first test your listening skills, and also I have prepared some nice questions for you to answer and consolidate the knowledge you are gaining today. Ready? Let's go.
Oh. Oh, dear.
Is something wrong, Pidge?
It's morning.
Yeah. So it is.
I should have been home hours ago.
Why? Because you still believe in that ever-faithful old dog tray routine?
Fill in the blanks using the same structure you just saw in the clip. My internet service got cut off because I didn't pay my bill. We couldn't get a table at the restaurant because we didn't have a reservation. I should have paid my internet bill. We should have made a reservation.
Oh, come on, Pidge. Open up your eyes.
Open my eyes?
To what a dog's life can really be. Show you what I mean. Look down there. Tell me what you see.
Well, I see nice homes with yards and fences.
Exactly. Life on a leash.
What does Tramp mean with the phrase life on a leash? A life without limits? A life without forests? a life without freedom.
Look again, Pidge. Look, there's a great big hunk of world down there with no fence around it. But two dogs can find adventure and excitement. And beyond those distant hills, who knows what wonderful experiences.
Complete the sentences using the correct form of the words in brackets. The kid opened the present to see what he'd gotten for his birthday. This movie is so... it's full of action, fights, and explosions. When she heard she'd gotten the job, she couldn't hide her... The kid excitedly opened the present to see what he'd gotten for his birthday. This movie is so exciting. It's full of action, fights, and explosions. When she heard she'd gotten the job, she couldn't hide her excitement.
Thanks for nothing. Bye.
Lady,
you and your friend better be careful. I smell an intruder afoot.
Oh, that's him, Trusty.
Leave the police work to me.
Oh, no, it's Officer Trusty. Help. Just in the nick of time.
Hey.
Fill in the blanks to complete the expression you just heard. Just in the of time. Just in the nick of time.
Don't push it!
Keep your scarf on, killer.
Okay, you two, thank you for the backup, but he was just leaving. Weren't you? Street dog?
Street dog?
Oh, I got it. I'll go, but only because I'm free to leave while all of you are stuck behind your fences.
What is another way of saying street dog? Lost dog? Stray dog? Scratch dog? Alright, now it's time for the comment of the day. The comment of the day comes from the Super Mario lesson, and this user, Gold Park, says, I am a Korean student learning English. Thank you so much for the cute video. I hope the day will come when I understand you soon, and I won't give up, and I will always continue to challenge myself. I hope everyone is always happy. Alright, Gold Park, thank you so much for the cute, wonderful comment. I really appreciate that. And keep watching our videos. All right, but now I have a challenge for you today. Do you remember that earlier in the lesson today, we learned 8 variations of the word care? My challenge for you today is, can you write one sentence using each one of these variations? Create your sentences, post them here in the comment of this video. I'm looking forward to seeing them, and I will select one of your comments to actually give you feedback and correct your sentences in a future video. All right, guys, awesome. You've made it until the end of the lesson. Great job, you rock, right? Don't forget to like this video, share this video with a friend who's also learning English, and subscribe to the channel in case you're not a subscriber yet. And if you want to keep learning English while having a lot of fun, check out this lesson next. See you soon.
Excuse me. Excuse me, everybody, coming through! This guy's brother is going to die imminently! Out of the way, please!
Just trying to clear a path, that's all I'm doing. He's gonna be fine.
Chantrell, nice to see you, bud.
Does this thing work?
Yes, we're great. You just have to blow into it.
And up we go.
Wait up.